brief update on our weather condition.
Based on the latest information, we've been in constant communication, so really over the last week, we've had several approaches we've approved. Talked with the National Weather Service. This first graphic you see illustrates the actual observed rainfall that we've had since Friday. You can see the area of Lowndes County there, it's kind of a yellow, mix of yellow, orange, and red. So that means really up in the north part of the county, we've had 3 inches plus rain, and down there, the bottom toward Lake Park and Clydeville, that represents 5 to 6 inches of rain. We've already received, as of this morning, since Friday. We've been able to handle that pretty well. You probably noticed as you come in, the heavy rains we've got now, Ashley Street, some of the normal areas that we see will cool up, we're starting to see that. This is, as of about 8 o'clock this morning, when I put this together, this is what the radar images look like. So you can see there's over pretty much all of South Georgia and Alabama, we've got that big line of rain that's moving through. So it's pretty much going to be with us all day. We're expecting to get, you know, more rain like it is now pretty much the rest of the day. And if you look kind of to the upper left, you see another little area there, and they're expecting that today, tonight, that storm system's going to move through as well. And when that one comes through, we're expecting not only the rain to continue, but also that one brings with it a little better chance of some higher winds, some severe thunderstorms, that nature. So we might be up for a little bit of a review. This is the graphic that the National Weather Service put out just this morning. Fortunately, from what we got last night, they have at least reduced our rainfall totals. They expect us to get a little bit. Last night, we were looking at 6 inches. Now we're down to about 5. Another inch of rain is going to make a tremendous amount of difference. But one of the key things we're going to watch is the 4 to 6 inches in that area of the shade above us. The rain that we see falling up now, once it stops raining, that's going to flow off pretty quickly. So the flash flooding is not really our primary concern right now. What we're going to have to keep an eye on really over the next week is to see how much rain falls and where it falls to the north of us, because that's what is going to affect our rivers later in the week. That water moving downstream. That's kind of what happened back in 09 when we flooded. We've got a lot of rain to our north. It's moving through our river roads and we experienced flooding. Unfortunately, we don't think this event is going to reach that magnitude. You can see this is, as of 8:05, this is the latest forecast. And this is for the river gauge that we have at over the Whitman Beach River there, Skipper Bridge Road. Forecasting it to reach 15.1 feet, which would be considered minor flooding. Really the only thing affected that level would be Greenville Park. I would caveat this to say, based on my past experience, and typically these forecasts change a lot, so we're not going to lock into a certain number. Basically what this does for us, it puts us in a mode that we need to constantly keep an eye on it. We've already citizens. If you live along the river, along the stream, then you need to pay close attention. They have a pretty good idea of when their properties start flooding. So we're telling everybody to keep a close eye on the river levels. These forecasts can do change, and as we get the rain, if more of the rain falls, out of our river basin, then we're going to be in good shape and it's not going to go as high. If we end up, it sits over us and Dunks Point and Tipton and Ashford and Fort Eagle and those areas are north, and obviously it is going to go higher. So monitoring will be working with our partners and sending out continuous updates as the Weather Service gives us any new information. But this is basically the latest. So we're going to try to get through the day with the heavy rains we've got, and then once the rains pass, it should be moved out by